Good afternoon, respected jury members, fellow presenters, and everyone listening. The poster I'll be presenting today is about the likelihood ratio as a binary classifier in forensic science. This poster will focus on sex estimation using certain long bones. Moving on to the next slide. As you can see, the likelihood ratio is a formula that suggests the ratio of probability of evidence given the same source. That is, evidence is from the suspect hypothesis over the probability of evidence given the different source. That is, another person hypothesis or a different person hypothesis. This ratio would give us the strength of the evidence. In other words, the more the likelihood ratio, the more confident we can be that the evidence is linked to the person involved in the crime. So if you could see, the numerator of this likelihood ratio, in other words, is like a similarity term. How similar is this evidence to the same source hypothesis? Whereas the denominator is it's like a typicality term. How typical is it to find this evidence from different sources? So this e-poster basically estimates sex by developing firstly a logistic regression equation using the predictors that we have used, is Humeris and Fortran, and also develop the likelihood ratio. We then compare the logistic regression with the likelihood ratio. Moving on. For this study, we've taken samples from 127 volunteers from Himachal Pradesh. We had 61 males and 66 females, and their age ranging from 18 to 56. The measurements that were taken were the humerus and the foot length. All this data was entered into an Excel spreadsheet and then analyzed by the R software. Moving on to the next slide. So the first step that we did was we fitted in a logistic regression model using the GLM function in R. So basically, a logistic regression is a statistical model that uses the logistic function to model a binary dependent variable, like a pass or a fail, a win or a lose. So in this case, it's a male or a female. Then we would take the logit function for various predictors, that's the humerus and the foot length, by the GLM function of R. This then leads to us tabulating the AIC and creating the ROC curve, which I'll explain later on. What we do next is we construct the probability density curve of the bone length by using the denom function that is also present in R, which uses the mean and the standard deviation. This is then, we use this to determine the likelihood ratio of the question bone length. Okay, so these are the results. As you can see, the first table is the statistical parameters of various anthropometric variables. So if we focus on the mean and the mean is very close to the median, which makes it a near normally distributed data. The next table indicates that the sex can be best estimated from the model having the lowest AIC. So according to this, we found out that the lowest AIC belongs to foot length. So the true positive rates for males and females were 77 and 82% respectively for foot length. The table following it is a table of true positive rates for the same variables, but this table is from just the likelihood ratios. So when we compare the likelihood ratio with the logistic regression, according to the graph, likelihood ratio is a much logical approach. It's a logical way of interpreting the evidence because it evaluates the strength of the evidence given the hypothesis, which is whether the male or the person is a male or a female. But with odds ratio, we actually calculate the probability of the hypothesis given the evidence, which is basically the other way around. Moving on to the next slide. Okay, so here you could see the ROC curves. ROC curves are basically it's the area. So as you can see, this is used for estimating sex. So higher the area under the ROC, better classification and estimation is done. So in this case, it's the foot length which also has higher area under the ROC graph. So if you could see these graphs, the probability density curves. So if you take example, the graph at the further bottom right, the foot length taken, like the questioned foot length recovery was 25 centimeters of length. So basically we'll have two competing hypotheses for this. One that the foot length belongs to a male and the other that it belongs to a female. So we will find the ratio of the probability of finding that foot length given the person is male over the probability of finding that foot length given the person is female. So simply we would use the mean and the standard deviation for that particular predictor, that is foot length in this case, versus males and females. So we'd use the denom function to find these two probabilities. The probability of this foot length belonging to a male was calculated to be 0.7, while the probability of the foot length belonging to a female was calculated to be 0.184. The ratio of these probabilities was 3.8, which indicates that the likelihood ratio is favoring male. On the other hand, if we switch the formula, if you would use probability of female over male, we would have got the ratio as 0.2, indicating it is not favorable to be a female bone. Moving on to the next slide. So in conclusion, this e-poster would report the estimation of sex from two bone lengths using the likelihood classifier with its threshold at 1. So since the previous example, we got the favoring of at 3 points, which is more than 1, we indicate that it was favorable to male. On the other hand, when we got the ratio as 0.2, indicating it is not favorable as it is less than the threshold. So the calculation of likelihood ratio is a very straightforward task using the probability density curve as well as the mean and the median, the mean and the standard deviation. So this performance of a likelihood ratio classifier is just a study, and according to this study, we found out that it's quite similar or almost equal to the logistic regression classifier. But a lot of further studies have to be done to explore how good the likelihood ratio is in the field of forensics. Thank you.